Hello, my name is Chris, and I'm the pastor at Kynos. On April 16th, 1963, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. wrote a letter from Birmingham Jail. Now, that letter was in response to a public letter that was published by 8 white pastors urging Dr. King and his black followers and protesters to abandon their direct action, meaning their protests and their marches and their sit-ins. Now, what these white pastors were in effect asking them to do was to take a step back and no longer cause any civil unrest. Now, Dr. King responds to them saying that their civil unrest was following a process that they took, a 4-step process of self-awareness, all the learning that you could do, negotiation, which they had already negotiated and their promises had been broken, self-purification, which they understood to be preparing for non-violent and peaceful protests, and then finally, direct action, protests, marches, sit-ins, etc. And he explains that this direct action is an effort to bring enough attention, to cause enough unrest, civil, peaceful unrest, to get conversations going again. To end that section of his letter, he says this: "Too long has our beloved Southland," and we can read that as our beloved United States, "too long has our beloved United States been bogged down in a tragic effort to live in monologue rather than in dialogue." And so here at Kynos, we want to live in dialogue. And so we have a couple of ways we are going to begin that. First and foremost, we are in fact getting back together again. All the COVID craziness has caused us to be away from each other for so long, and we need to be in community. So we're going to get back together and we're going to spend some nights worshiping on both June 14th and the 28th, both Sundays at 6 p.m. And they're going to be outdoor worship nights. And we're going to take all the necessary precautions in order to ensure that we are safe and obeying the laws and guidelines regarding our meeting. We are going to spend that time worshiping God, because in the midst of all of the sorrow and chaos, God is still good. We are also going to spend that time lamenting, expressing sorrow, repenting, forgiving and asking forgiveness, and beginning to start that process of dialogue together. Now, the other thing we are going to do is, you'll see in a few minutes, you're going to hear my sermon, and it's a bit different this week. And I offer 2 encouragements. One, let this be a start to your dialogue, and I offer myself as a dialogue partner if you wish me to be. You can get onto our website, kynossd.org, and fill out a contact sheet there. You can email me at chris@legacysd.org. You can find me on Instagram through the @kynossd account or @thisiscrward. Let's talk. The other thing that's going to help you in response to my sermon is in the description, we're putting some resources for you, some voices that need to be heard, some options and opportunities for you and I to listen to voices that for far too long have not been listened to. But before that, we are going to worship. And I want to encourage you now to get into a posture of worship, whatever that looks like for you, to quiet your heart, to prepare to meet with the living God, because I do believe he is in this space as much as he's in your space, wherever you are right now. And get ready to listen to what he has to say. And let us continue this process of dialoguing for many, many years to come. Thank you for being here. We love you.
Thank you.